Hello, welcome to this channel Gain Java Knowledge. And today in this video, we are going to learn what is AOP and why we need AOP and how to implement AOP in Spring Boot project. Okay, let's start first with what is AOP. AOP is an aspect-oriented programming paradigm to increase modularity by allowing the separation of cross-cutting concerns. These cross-cutting concerns are different from the main business logic. We can add additional behavior to existing code without modification of the code itself. And Spring AOP framework help us to implement these cross-cutting concerns. Using AOP, we can define common functionality in one place. For example, in our application, there are different layers, like controller, service, and DAO layers, and multiple layers. And the responsibility of these layers are different, like controller can be used to define URL path of API. Inside service layer, we can write our business logic. And inside DAO layer, we can use to write persistence logic, like save, get, or delete any operation we can perform. Then why we need AOP? Because we have three layers like controller, service, and DAO layer. But inside these three layers, like controller, service, and DAO, there are few common aspects that applying to all layers, like logging will be applied to all layers. And if we want to track the time execution for each API, that we can apply at any layer. And we can also provide security to any layer. So these are common cross-cutting concerns. And if we want to implement this common cross-cutting concern in each layer separately, then code becomes more difficult to maintain and we need to write duplicate codes in each method. So to overcome these types of problem, aspect-oriented programming provide a solution to implement these cross-cutting concerns. Then what are the benefits of AOP? So without modifying our business logic, we can add our secondary logic, that is cross-cutting concerns, and we can also say aspect. So here we can see we have already created one project and this is our controller layer. And inside our controller layer, we can see we have not added any logger statement here. And inside service implementation, we can also check. Here also I have not added any logger statement, but now requirement is that we need to add logger statement in each method. So if we have already created lots of classes and after that we need to add loggers, so it will take more time to add loggers in each class. So for this we can use Spring AOP that will create just single aspect and will handle all the classes. And logs will be printed in each class. So these are the main terminologies used in AOP. First is aspect. An aspect is a module that encapsulates advice and point cuts and provide cross-cutting concern. So an application have any number of aspect. And second main terminology is point cut. So what is point cut? A point cut is an expression that select one or more join points where advice is executed. So we can use point cut to define our expression. And third is join point. A join point is a point in the application where we apply an AOP aspect. And another one is advice. The advice is an action that we can take either before or after the method execution, and the action is a piece of code that invokes during the program execution. And there are five different type of advices: before advice, after returning, after throwing, and around advice. And today in this video, in this example, we are going to use around advice, because in this example we are going to implement centralized logging in our Spring Boot application using Spring AOP. Because as we know, logging part is a mandatory part in each project to track the root cause of an application failure. So here we can see I have already created one Spring Boot project. It is just a simple Spring Boot project that contains two REST endpoints. One is used to get the list of student and second endpoint is used to add the student into database. So now if I want to add logs in each method, then here I need to write lots of lines. And here we can see our business code is only one line. If I will write logs here and here, then there are, if there are multiple classes, then it will take lots of time to add the logs. So due to logs, the codes of line will be increased. So to resolve this type of issues and to reduce the lines of code, AOP come into picture. So we can place log statement and log statement code into common place, and we can use for each method without modifying its business logic. So here we will not add any statement or any logs, but log will be printed on console when this method will execute. For this we will use Spring AOP. And the main purpose of AOP is to separate the secondary logic from its business logic. So this is our business logic, and secondary logic means that logger statement we are going to add. Logs are secondary logic because without adding secondary logic here, we can execute our primary logic. So now we will see how we can write secondary logic using AOP and use before or after our primary logic. So this is our primary logic. So we will print one logger statement before this business logic and one logger statement after this. So for this, first we need to create one more package, that will be aspect package we will create here, because we need to create one aspect. So here what I will do, first I will create one package. And in single project, we can create any number of aspects. So here I will just create one new class, that is logging aspect. And to support Spring Boot AOP, we just need to add one more dependency inside our pom.xml. That is Spring Boot Starter AOP dependency we just need to add. So here I will add one more dependency, that is Spring Boot Starter AOP. After adding this dependency, I will go back to my controller class, and we have created our logging aspect here. Now I will go to class logging aspect, and here we just need to define annotation, that is @aspect. Then Spring Boot will understand this is our aspect. And here we also need to define annotation @component. And here we are going to implement centralized logging for our Spring Boot project. So here I will add cell4j. I already have added Lombok dependencies. So here I am going to use @cell4j annotation to print the logs. So here we just need to define one method inside our aspect, so that will be public object, and logging advice, we can define any name for our method. And inside this method we just need to pass one parameter, that is proceeding join point PG. And here we just need to define the annotation, that is @aroundAdvice. And inside around device, we can directly define the name of our point cut method name. So first I will write the logic here. Like first we need to create object mapper. So that object mapper will be used to convert our object into as a string JSON object. So first what I will do, first I need to get the method name. So pj.getSignature, and inside signature we will get the name. So it will give me the method name. Like this we can get the class name. Get class name. So So we just need to call jp.getTarget. Get target, and inside get target we need to call get class, and we can convert into toString. So like this we have got our method name and class name. Now I also want to print request body or request parameter in our logs. So what I will do here, I will just use object of array, that is request parameters. So here I will just call get arrays method. Get arguments method, so it will return me all the arguments. Now I just need to print these all attributes value inside our logs. So here I will just like inside class name so this is our class name. And next we can print our method name. And method name will be like this method. And with request parameter that we want to print or request body. Mapper dot write string into value. Write value as a string, and here we just need to pass our array object. So this will execute, and so this code was just to print the request body or parameter. And if we also want to track the response of our methods, for this we are going to use here @arounddevice. Because as we know, arounddevice annotation is the combination of @before and @after returning annotation. So our this code will be execute before our primary logic. So these codes of line that we have written in aspect, it will execute before our primary logic. And after getting the response back from method, we also want to print few more logs. Means after returning the response, we want to print the logs. Then we need to write few lines of code here. So object response, and here we just need to call tj dot get tj dot proceed method we need to call. And this proceed method is returning an object. This object is nothing but the response returned by method. And after returning the response by method, we also want to print few logs. So I will just copy these logs and we'll paste it here. And here I will just copy response and print here. And after that, I will just return the response back. Now we need to learn how Spring Boot will understand when and where we need to execute this logic or code log statement that we have written in our aspect. For this, Spring Boot has provided one annotation, that is @pointcut annotation. And the role of pointcut annotation is to inform Spring AOP where I want to execute this piece of code. So here I will just define one more method, and at this method I will define the annotation, that is @pointcut. So here I will define public void logging pointcut. And at method level I will define annotation, that is @pointcut. And inside pointcut we need to define the expression so Spring Boot will understand where and when we need to execute this code of aspect. So here our requirement is I want to implement logging concept in our whole application. So inside @point cut annotation, I will just need to define the path of its root directory. So here @point cut, we just need to define value, and inside value we just need to define execution, and inside execution we just need to define the return type of the method. If we don't care about return type, that will be different for any method. So here we will write star, and here we just need to define the root directory path. So here we can see the path of our root directory, that is com.example.login.api.demo. So here I will go and just copy up to here before aspect, copy it, and now I will go here and just paste it here. And further, any package, any parameter, any class name and any method name, we can, it will execute for any method. And if we don't know the number of parameters, it can be any number of parameters. Now we just need to copy our logging point cut name and just need to add here inside our around advice. So it will use this expression, and here we just need to throw and handle the exception. And if we want to specify logging aspect only in any specific class or only for a some specific method, then we need to change only expression value here. Like we can write here package name, like if you want to implement inside our controller, and inside controller we just want to implement inside our message controller or student controller. So here we just need to define the class name, and if you just want to use it for specific method, then here we just need to define method name get students. And we do not know how much parameter inside this method, so we can add two dots here, so it will handle. But here our requirement is we need to add logging in our whole Spring Boot application, so we want to do centralized logging. So here we are just adding star star, so it will work for all package, all classes and all methods. So here we can see we have not added any logs, but we have just created one logging aspect. Now we need to start our application and need to check if it's working or not. So here what I will do, I will just run our application, run as Java application. And here we can see our application has started. So first I will clear all the logs. Now I will go to Postman, and here first I will hit get students API, because in our project we have just created two API. One is used to get student and second is used to add the student. So here I will call first API, and here I am just getting the list of student in response and with 200 OK response. Now I will go and check the console logs. So here we can see inside class student controller class get student method with request empty, because inside get we are not passing any parameter or request body. But when we are getting the response, here we can see the response that we are getting from database. So here we can see these loggers are inside student controller class, and this logger for student service implementation class, and this is again for student service implementation class with response, and inside student controller class again with response. Like this we can test our post API. So here I will go and just copy one object from here and copy it and go to add student, and here we just need to send the request. So here we are getting 200 OK. Now I will check the logs on console. So here we can see our logging aspect class has executed, and here we can see our request that we have used to add the student. So with the request ID null, first name, last name, everything we can see. in the logs and inside response what we are getting. We are getting back ID 16. During request our ID was null. So here we can see while returning response back from post database we are getting its ID 16 also. In request it was null. So like this we can add or implement centralized logging in our Spring Boot application. Okay, thanks for watching this video.